Hello, this is Tom from everystepcalculus.com, everystepphysics.com. There's been a lot of searches for dydx calculator, which is really a derivative calculator. And of course, my programs are exactly for that and solve hundreds of problems coming from your tests or homework step by step. So I'm going to show you how this works with the product rule. Again, simple derivatives like x to the 10th power or something like that, I haven't programmed because you should know that by yourself. In other words, x to the 10 would be 10 times, no, 10 times x to the 9. And you should just say that, be able to say that in 1 second, because that's what calculus is. That's what the classes are about, is that simple calculation there. But learn to do it quickly. Practice that always. And same thing with integrals, where you add one to the exponent and divide by the answer. In other words, x to the 3rd power, you'd be x to the 4th divided by 4. So remember that in your calculus studies. Index 8 to get to my menu. I'm going to go up to, because product rule is closer to W than A, so you can go up and get to the bottom of the alphabet. These are all alphabetical. Get to the P. There's product rule. Click. Shows you the formula. You write this on your paper just exactly as you see it, so you know what you're doing. You have to put it in this format: open parenthesis, close parenthesis, times, open parenthesis, close parenthesis. So I'm going to do that now. You have to press alpha before you enter anything into these entry lines. You press alpha first. I'm going to put the parentheses in so I don't mess them up. And then go back and times. So now I got the parentheses in here. I'm going to take this back on the cursor and get inside the parentheses and add my function, which is 3 times x minus 2 times x squared. And then I'm going to go over here and get into the other functions parentheses and add 5 plus 4 times x. I always show you what you've entered, so you get a chance to change it if you want. Here's the two functions, and here's the calculations. Here's the answer. I also give you the chance of, if you want to do it at a point, for instance, a point here, you have to press alpha, and let's do it at 3, alpha 3. Say it's okay. We enter 3 for all the x's in the function. And here's the answer, minus 162 over 1. Now notice this is rise over run, okay? And all the derivative does from 650 pages in your calculus book is find the slope of a line, okay? And this is the slope, minus 162 over 1. You'd go minus 162 increments on the y-axis, all the way down, go over 1 on the right axis, and then draw a line from that point through the origin of the graph. That's the what you found is the slope of that line there. It's not tangent. You have to go to my equation of a tangent line program to come up with the formula to so that it's tangent at this point. Pretty neat, huh? Everystepcalculus.com. Go to my site, subscribe to me if you want. See other movies. Have a good one.